Hi mommies, this is Tanya, Noor's mom. So today I'm going to be telling you all about pacifiers. So first, what is a pacifier? A pacifier is nothing but an object made of plastic or silicone in the shape of a nipple that helps babies satisfy their sucking reflex. So now let's talk about your baby's sucking reflex. So babies have a very strong sucking or suckling reflex, and this is mostly developed right from when they are in the womb, right from when they are in your tummy. So you must have seen, you know, in your some babies and even in their scans, when you have those last scans, some babies are found sucking their thumb or toes. So it's very common, and it's a very natural phenomena that babies have, which basically helps calm them and helps them feel safe. Now, what are the different kinds of pacifiers available? So first is the material. Now, there are three materials available. One is silicone, latex, and plastic. So out of all these three, I would recommend that you should give your babies silicone, because that material is the safest for your baby. Next category of the types are, pacifiers are a single piece pacifiers. Let me show you one. So this is a single piece pacifier. One piece, the entire thing is made out of one piece. The other kinds are a multi-piece pacifier. So I have this here. This is a Kiko pacifier. So now this is a multi-piece. This is made of plastic, but the bulb here is made of silicone. So this is this second kind of pacifier. So again, it is recommended that you use the single piece pacifier. Why? Because with multi-piece, plastics can come off and can probably be ingested by the baby or even pose a choking hazard. But if it's not available or your baby doesn't like the single piece one, don't worry about it. Just be mindful of this. And the last thing that I'm talking about is the kind of bulb of the pacifier. So one is a normal pacifier, which either looks like this, which is in the shape of a nipple, or it is basically rounded, or these days this has become very popular, which is called orthodontic pacifiers. So these are flat at the bottom, as you can see, and they are rounded at the top. So now these have been designed by pediatric dentists. And they are designed in a way, as you can see the flat bottom, that they don't interfere with the development of baby's teeth and jaws. And these ones are also, so because of their shape, when the baby sucks them, they become flat, just like when your baby sucks your breast nipple. So that is why these are most recommended by pediatricians, because they don't interfere that much with the teeth development and also give your baby the same kind of experience that the baby has while sucking from the breast. So this was all about pacifier types. Now, when should we start pacifiers? So if you're bottle feeding your baby right from the start, you can start giving your baby a pacifier right from day one. So mostly internationally, this is what the practice is. But in case you're breastfeeding your baby, it is advised by AAAP, which is American Academy of Pediatrics, that you should start giving your baby a pacifier only after 4 weeks, that is 1 month, so that the baby is settled with and has established that breastfeeding routine and is latched onto your nipple, and it doesn't cause nipple confusion. But there is no research to back this. There are also hundreds and millions of breastfeeding moms all across the world who have given their babies pacifier right from day one, and there has been no nipple confusion. So it is absolutely your choice, but just if you want to go by medical guidelines, then it is advised that you give your baby a pacifier only 4 weeks after the baby is born. Now, what are the advantages of using a pacifier? Number one, which I spoke earlier, it satisfies the baby's suckling reflex, which is very strong, and they have this strong you know, reflex of sucking things. That is why, because it calms them. So this is the number one benefit. The second is it helps your baby self-soothe themselves. You know, in case your baby is very fussy or cranky, or general, if there's fear about something, or there is anxiety, your baby is, you know, is scared of something, or even it can help with colicky babies. So it really helps babies self-soothe themselves. Third is it helps babies sleep. So I get a lot of messages from breastfeeding moms also, who say that my babies get up in at night and they just want to suckle on my breast, and within 5 minutes they sleep. So this is that suckling reflex that actually helps them sleep, and they are actually waking you up just to suckle so that they can be at calm and peace, that now we have that mechanism going on and we can now calmly sleep. So this is another advantage, that babies can sleep themselves also. The next thing is that during flights, if you're taking a flight, then it's very good, because during flights what happens is, the especially takeoff and landing, the air pressure changes and your baby's ears, even our adults' ears, they get blocked. So pacifiers help in releasing that. Then pacifiers can help reduce the risk of SIDS, which is sudden infant death syndrome. Below 6 months of age this happens. So if your baby is sucking on the pacifier at night, there is less chances that your baby can be suffocated by anything else. Then the next thing is that it can be a great, great source of temporary distraction. Like just after vaccination, your baby is in a mess, crying. So that is, or after giving medicines to your baby, it can act as a distraction. Also, it is better than the thumb sucking habit. Because with thumb sucking, the problem is that that is the baby's thumb. It is in baby's control. And baby, the moment you take it out, baby can put it in inside. But with pacifiers, you are in control of the pacifier. If you take it away and put it somewhere, that's it, it's gone, right? It is also easier to break this habit rather than the thumb sucking habit. So these were the benefits of pacifiers. Now let's talk about the disadvantages. So number one disadvantage, very, very difficult habit to break. Babies really get dependent on it. Second, if pacifiers are used above 6 months, it can cause middle ear infection. So there's a risk of it. I'm not saying every baby will get it, but your baby might get it. Third, if you do not wean pacifier at the right age, which I'm going to be speaking about later, then it can cause a problem of teeth development of baby. Your babies can have misaligned teeth, can have a problem of overbite or open bite, like the upper jaw is protruding more than the lower jaw. Your baby can have a deep palate. So all these problems can come. And lastly, the last disadvantage of a pacifier is that it can cause nipple confusion in breastfeeding babies. Like I mentioned earlier, if you start before the first month the baby is born, but there is no research to back this. So, I mean, it's completely your choice. Now, what are the precautions while using pacifiers? Number one, very important, it should be BPA free, it should be lightweight. Buy a pacifier that is age appropriate. So pacifiers usually come with age guidelines, 0 to 6 months, 6 to 16 months. So buy according to your baby's age. Third, pacifiers can be a great risk source of infection. Why? Because they're always in the baby's mouth. So just like bottles and teethers that we continuously sterilize, you need to sterilize and clean your baby's pacifier every time they use it. Even if it drops at the floor or the bed, it needs to be washed or sterilized again as per the instructions given on the pacifier. Then do not put any sugar or honey on the pacifier. No, that pacifier is enough to calm your baby. Then do not give your baby pacifier as the first line of defense. So like the moment your baby starts crying, you give it. No, first check where is your baby hungry. So sometimes what happens, baby is hungry and we give the pacifier. So the baby's hunger also gets masked. So no, first check whether baby is bored or hungry or tired. Check for these things. If nothing works, then offer a pacifier. Lastly, I would say if you have an older carer also at home who uses a pacifier, don't let your babies share pacifiers. Can be a great source of infections, which is not safe for either of the babies. So this was all about precautions. Now about weaning. So like I said earlier, if you don't wean pacifier at the right age, it can cause dental problems. So the American Academy of Pediatrics recommends that you should only use pacifier till 1 year of age and try to wean it off before that. But mostly that is not possible. So more health organizations in the world have done their research, and even pediatric dentists have come to this conclusion that maximum till 2 or 3 years you should wean the pacifier off. Why? So what happens is that even if your baby has developed some problem in their teeth till 2 to 3 years old, the moment you let go of the pacifier, within 6 months those problems self-correct themselves. They will get okay on their own and there will be no problem to the new adult teeth that are coming in. But if you extend it for too long, if you let your baby use the pacifier for longer than 3 or 4 years, then is when problems start, and those damages cannot be reversed, because inside a baby's jaws, the permanent teeth, the adult teeth, start developing by 4 years of age. So the right age is actually 1 year. If you can't wean off by 1 year, I would say 2 to 2.5 years max. Do not stretch it for more than 3 years if you want your baby's teeth to be all right. Now this was all about pacifiers, and I know it is a very controversial topic, a lot of debate about it, that you should not give it, pediatricians never recommend them. But to be honest, for some parents it is an important part of their baby's lives, and it's absolutely okay if you decide to use it. Just keep in mind that you need to wean it off at the right age. Now my experience with it is that I am myself a pacifier baby, so I am very okay with the concept, and even my family is. So we initially used to give Noor pacifiers only when she was very fussy. This is when she was below 6 months of age, and she used to sleep with it, especially when during stroller walks. She wasn't very fond of them till 6 months, only once or twice here and there, that's all. But now when she grew up, she got into the habit of she had become very heavy, and she wanted me to rock her all night long, and it was getting difficult for me, for my back. So for my own sanity, I started giving her a pacifier, and now she sleeps with the pacifier. I don't need to rock her or anything or feed her. It's the pacifier that makes her sleep, and I am very happy with it also. And I'm okay if it's a habit that is difficult to break, because I am at peace right now, and this is what is most important. So it's absolutely okay if you are also using it. I had to use it because otherwise I couldn't have gone further any longer. I could not have managed her. It was getting very difficult to manage her. So which pacifier am I using for Noor right now? So as you all know, I'm using the Dr. Brown's Happy Passy for Noor. She only accepts this right now. She does not accept the orthodontic pacifiers, probably because she has been more of a bottle fed baby, and this is nothing but the bottle nipple attached. So this is very different from a normal pacifier. This is just the bottle nipple attached here. So she gets the feeling of she's drinking milk from her bottle. So she does not accept any of the other ones that I showed you, the orthodontic pacifiers, but I'm trying my best to make her use those, because these can only be used till 12 months, and in case she decides to use it later, I'm going to be in a lot of problem, because this I cannot give this to her later on. One thing that I want to say, that there are various brands available in the market. The best ones are Kiko, Philips Avent, and Dr. Brown's. But please note that every baby is different, and what works for my baby what might not work for your baby. I had to try 10 different pacifiers when we initially started to reach to this perfect one for her. So you might also have to try lots of them before you find the right pacifier. So that's all about it, and I hope this video was helpful.